Welcome to my Balls to the Wall Scumbag DPS Ravana Extreme Mode Guide. This video will guide all of you Dragoons to maximize your DPS during Ravana Extreme. Monks and Ninjas can also take snippets from this guide of how I handle mechanics and apply it to your own tactics. This isn't necessarily a step-by-step mechanic guide for the raid encounter either, and this video will already assume that you know how the mechanics work, but you may still learn something from this guide even if you're completely new to the encounter. So let's begin. The first mechanic, the seeing, happens at exactly 10 seconds into the encounter. The trick is to attack at the same time as your tank. This will allow you to fit either your wheeling thrust or your fang and claw perfectly, hitting your positional and not getting your DPS struck by RNG. The important part about the seeing is that the knockback plus slow debuff only takes into effect when the animation is up, so depending on your global cooldown patterns, you might be able to sneak a second one in while circling Ravana to avoid the parry attack. One other good tip is that Ravana never parries in the same place twice, so if she's using seeing right for example, then you should position yourself to the right after she's finished parrying. This just helps outpace your fourth combos a tiny bit easier, and also allows you to hit your positionals. Next, we have Prelude to Liberation, where Ravana is now taking additional damage and casting a massive AoE. This phase lasts approximately 30 seconds, but as long as you have correctly managed your Blood of the Dragon, you should be able to pop two Gist Goggles in before having to turn around and run to the edge, avoiding the AoE. Unfortunately, in this particular example, I was too slow pressing my first Gist Goggle, so I never managed to fit in my second one just before the phase change. You want to burn off your Blood of the Dragon here. Many people also hold their cooldowns and use it for this part of the phase. No. Burn them all at the start, it makes sense later. During the Liberation AoE phase, try positioning yourself as center as possible, even if you have the purple AoE on you. This will allow you to be ahead of the next timer and fit in more global cooldowns during the next phase, which lasts 20 seconds. Now, this is the phase that makes or breaks a Dragoon. If you used all of your cooldowns at the beginning of the fight, like you should have, right at the start of this phase, you should have Internal Release, Blood for Blood, Power Surge, Jump, and Life Surge all ready to go. These are the cooldowns you'll want to pop here, as once again, Ravana is taking additional damage. And please, Dragoons, do not be tempted to pop Blood of the Dragon here. Hold it, as you'll never be able to keep it up in time for the next phase, and it's an overall raid DPS decrease. Trust me on this, hold it for the next phase, it makes complete sense. Also, I never popped Blood for Blood here, as with a 5 DPS solo tank composition, it throws the timings off slightly. I decided to hold it and get the full effect of Blood for Blood on the next phase. However, if you're using a standard composition of 2 tanks, 4 DPS, just use it on this phase, it should be up. The perfect rotation for this phase is Heavy Thrust, Impulse Drive, Disembowel, and then 2 Full Thrust combos. This should get you the absolute maximum damage during this phase. And now we just have to dodge the cars. Vroom vroom. Once we get back onto Ravana, it's now safe for us to use Blood of the Dragon, as you can actually keep it up. Again, Ravana will use the seeing, and yes, you may get screwed by the positioning sometimes. It happens. There's nothing you can do about it, and the only way to mitigate this is by having more skill speed. Add phase, and this is where damage padding comes into play. First, you want to keep Blood of the Dragon up for as much as you can. Due to the fact that you're going to lose 1 second per tab target moving between adds, it's kind of unwise to be throwing Gist Goggles all over the place. You want to keep Blood of the Dragon up as, secondly, you want to blow all your Gist Goggles on Ravana just before she uses her ultimate. Thirdly, dot uptime. If you want to be a sneaky DPS, throw some phlebotomizers up on Ravana. Use your Chaos Frost combos on the Naga Moons, and then throw the Chaos Frost on actually Ravana. It all contributes to your overall DPS and increases your numerical raid DPS for handling a mechanic. It's cheating, I know, and you should be focusing your DPS on the ads, but who cares, you're scumbag DPS. Also, do Do not use the Blood of the Dragon cooldown during this phase either. You want to keep juggling your current duration up so you have a cooldown ready at your disposal for the next phase. After Ravana's ultimate, she'll then use Pillars of Heaven. What I like to do is Heavy Thrust, Impulse Drive and then Disembowel. You'll be knocked away anyway, so you might as well take advantage of this and have Disembowel up before you start blowing all of your cooldowns. Also, if you can squeeze her for the bottomizing, that's even better. Spine Shatter Drive, back to Ravana, blow your cooldowns, potions, head straight for that burst. So my cooldown timings will be slightly different than if you were using 4 DPS 2 tanks. Take that into consideration, but all of your potions should be up during this phase. Now here's the real scumbag part. If you jump back to Ravana and started attacking her straight away after Pillars of Heaven, you can actually keep your Blood of the Dragon up during orb phase. The orbs spawn exactly 30 seconds after Pillars of Heaven and should spawn in the middle of a Chaos Thrust combo. The trick is to position yourself at maximum distance from Ravana and keep attacking until you either hit a Disembowel or a Chaos Thrust, and the second you see your animation, run. The orbs only start moving once the line have started tethering, and the second you see the lines disappear, go back and attack Ravana. The timing here is very critical and extremely risky to pull off, as you could block one of the orbs and give your raid vulnerability, accidentally be enraged for one of the orbs when they blow up and give yourself a vulnerability, or even mistime your movements and lose out on Blood of the Dragon altogether, giving you an overall raid DPS decrease. It's a very scummy move on my behalf, endangering the entire raid for my own DPS, but whatever, if I'm not first, I'm last. Swift Liberation is another part where Ravana is taking increased damage. Unfortunately, you won't have any of the cooldowns up here, as you want to blow all of your Jizz Goggle stacks just before you run to handle the sword mechanic. If you have Blood of the Dragon available for whatever reason, hold it for the next phase. Final Liberation is Double Prey, aka Panic Phase, aka Coordination Phase, aka Wipe Phase. Do not use Blood of the Dragon here either, as this is a 20 second phase and you cannot keep it up. However, I did a misclick here and I did use Blood of the Dragon. If this was any other scenario, you'd want to hold it. Do not misclick. Many other groups also handle this mechanic differently, and if there is a demand for it, I'll go over a few of the different ways to handle this double prey mechanic in another video, as it's really interesting to see what other groups do to handle it. Warlord Shell. Now this is the DPS check of this raid encounter. You have to burst this down as fast as you can, otherwise he'll knock everyone off the platform and deal 25,000 damage for an instant raid wipe. The ultra scummy scumbag way is to not use any cooldowns here, as you're dealing 0 damage, and let your other DPS deal with it, allowing you to have a full, proper burst after this mechanic, inflating your DPS. However, I'm not that much of an arsehole, so I blew all my cooldowns just to get rid of the bubble as fast as possible, and try and be a bit of a team player. From here, it's just a repeat of mechanics, so use everything I taught you and capitalize on the mechanics. As this is a 5 DPS composition, we did skip a few of the repeated mechanics in the end, as our overall raid DPS was high, and this also gave us just under an 8 minute clear. And there you have it, my extreme Ravana DPS guide. Hopefully this guide will help you, my fellow Dragoons, maximize your DPS during Ravana, as I know many people are struggling with their DPS in this encounter. So guys, thank you for watching, take care, and as always, I'll see you guys next time.